flood, all the colors came out. In 1975, Italian footballer Giuseppe Sovoldi became the first £1 million transfer, moving from Bologna to Napoli for £1,200,000. In 1992, Frenchman Jean-Pierre Papin broke the transfer record, moving from Marseille to AC Milan for £10 million. In 2001, Frenchman Zinedine Zidane again broke the record, moving from Juventus to Real Madrid for a massive £46.5 million. Then, in 2009, Portuguese superstar Cristiano Ronaldo nearly doubled this fee, moving from Manchester United to Real Madrid for £80 million. And finally, the most recent record-breaking transfer was Welshman Gareth Bale, who in 2013 moved from Tottenham Hotspur to Real Madrid for £85 million.
In recent years, many fans, players and pundits have started saying that money has ruined football.
Are they right?
I'm not sure, so I'm on a mission to find out whether money has ruined the beautiful game. And my first stop, Godalming Town Six-A-Side League, to see what the players think. Do you think that the vast sums of money in today's game have decreased the atmosphere in football matches?
I'd say so. I'd say the top clubs are more of a business rather than a football club.
And I think the higher the prices, the lower the atmosphere.
No, I don't think it has, but it just means less people can go because they can't afford it.
There always seems to be a lot of negative talk about money in football. Do you feel that money has made some positive impacts on today's game?
I think it has, because there's more facilities around the club. So, for example, teams can scout players worldwide and recruit better players. So it's not just English players.
Yeah, definitely with the quality of players that's in the Premier League. When you look 10 years ago, there was probably two top teams, United and Liverpool, and now there's multiple, six. Everton's starting to create a bit of a challenge.
Which area of football do you think has changed the most because of money?
I think transfers, because when you look at examples of Gareth Bale going for £85 million from Real Madrid, people that aren't interested in football and see that on the news, they get an interest in it, and it's created a much larger fan base.
I think transfers, because richer clubs obviously can buy better players. So, for example, City, they've got so much income, they can just buy the best players in the world, so other teams such as, I don't know, Sunderland can't really compete with them, not they expect them to. But it's mainly just going to go to the top teams. For example, United, City, Chelsea is pretty much the rich clubs that are just going to compete.
I'd say wages.
Yeah.
Players are getting hundreds, thousands of pounds a week. Take Tevez on 360 grand a week, which is just ridiculous amount of money.
I'm on my way to the Kingfield Stadium to see my local team Woking play Kidderminster, and I'm hoping there's going to be a fair few goals. It'd be good to get the fans' point of view, because at the end of the day, they are the ones paying the money to see their team play week in, week out. So I can imagine they're going to have quite a strong viewpoint on it.
Number 9, Michael Nash.
Do you think the
think the vast sums of money in today's game have decreased the atmosphere in football matches?
No, personally I think what's decreased the atmosphere is the fact they got rid of standing in the late 80s, early 90s. When they had standing, you'd get more people in the ground and there was a general better atmosphere.
Despite all the negativity, do you feel that money has made some positive impacts in today's game?
I think it's had a huge impact on football nowadays because there's now money being pumped into the grassroots system for football, so younger people getting more opportunities to play football around the country. They're getting better coaching staff, better facilities.
Overall, do you think money has changed the game for good or for bad?
I think for bad, because it's ruined the competitiveness, especially in the Premier League. Like, the lower divisions are still competitive, like League 1, League 2, Championship, but the Premier League just isn't competitive anymore. You know, years and years ago, Division 1 used to be really competitive. Every team could win it, but now it's just except 4 or 5 teams can win it.
Overall, do you think money has changed the game for good or for bad?
I think the money in football has changed football as a game for good because of what we just said. So the coaching has got better, which means the standard of football has got better around the country.
Finished 1-0 to Woking here at the Kingfield Stadium. Not as many goals as we'd like, but nevertheless, a great result for the Cards. Well, there you have it. I think it's hard to say whether money's ruined the game or not. Obviously, there's mixed opinions. On the positive side, it's brought the best talent to the UK, improved safety and facilities. On the negative side, many believe that the passion and atmosphere has decreased due to the vast amounts of money that have been pumped into the game. At the end of the day, everyone's entitled to their own opinion, and I'm going to leave you to decide yours.
They get an interest in it, and it's created a much larger fan base.